Hey guys, it's Micah here from the Coomer Homestead. In today's video, I want to show you how we built a plastic-free, zero-maintenance watering system for our chickens. But before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel and you click on the little alert button so you get notified when we publish more videos like this. When we bought our coop, and you can watch a separate video here, a video tour that we did of our American coop, a Carolina coops, but when we got that coop, we got with it a watering system that we wouldn't have to maintain very much. And you can see the two components of this watering system here. One is a plastic rain barrel and the other one is a PVC pipe with nipples on it. And so the whole system is gravity fed. So that means you fill in the water, you connect the hose to this side of the pipe and a return to the other side. There was actually a recirculation pump in between. And it also came with a bucket heater. So the whole system meant that we never had to refill the water because rain would refill it. And it would also prevent the water from freezing because the bucket heater would kick in once the temperatures reached 35 degrees Fahrenheit and the recirculation pump that would pump water out of the barrel and through this pipe here would also kick in when the temperatures were low. So the water could never freeze. It would recirculate the warm water and the chickens couldn't mess anything up because there was no way to poop in it into the water. They could simply feed by pecking at that nipple here, that would water come out, and super convenient. And the reason why we changed this system to something that we rebuilt from scratch was because the barrel is plastic and PVC is obviously plastic too. And if you've seen any of my other videos or blog posts, then you know that all the plastics, even the food grade plastics, have estrogenic chemicals or endocrine disrupting chemicals that can leach into the water at room temperatures or higher. And in the Georgia sun, once, you know, when the barrel heats up and the pipe heats up, there is a lot of estrogenic leaching going on that ends up in the water that the chickens then drink and we might eat either their meat or their eggs. And we didn't want that. We don't want any estrogenics in our bodies and certainly not in the chickens' bodies either. So we decided to rebuild the whole system, reusing or borrowing the concept, but doing it in a way that would be plastic free for the most part. So here is what we did. We got an old wine barrel from Lowe's, relatively inexpensively, and we cleaned it out. So we, you know, hosed it down, put in some baking soda, let it soak for a little bit, rinsed it out, refilled it, did the same thing again, because the first time we put in water and we opened the spigot here, there was red colored water coming out, an indication that there was red wine in the barrel before. And we don't want our chickens to get drunk. So we rinse it out thoroughly. And then one of the first things we did is we drilled a hole up here with a spade bit. It's like our overflow protection here. So if there is too much water coming in, the water would then start flowing out at this point. We covered it with a mesh wire so that mosquitoes and other debris cannot get in. And then we drilled a second hole down here that would fit the spigot. So depending on what spigot you're getting, drill a hole with a spade bit that's big enough in diameter. And then I used simply some Teflon tape around the spigot. It's a metal spigot here. And I screwed it in. And the first time I did this and I filled it with water, it was leaking all around the spigot. And I'm like, oh boy, this is not gonna work. But the reason why it was leaking was because the wood was, or the barrel wasn't filled with any water in a while. So the wood had contracted. But as soon as we filled in the water and let it stand for a couple of days, it expanded and it sealed everything off nicely. So don't be discouraged if your spigot here is leaking right after installing everything. From the spigot here, we have a sediment filter that I installed. So in case there is anything, you're gonna see it here then on the side or on the side and in the close-up. But here we have a hole as well. And just to make sure that there is no debris getting in into the water supply, that is, we have a sediment filter here. And installed to that is, or added to that is, a charcoal filter. And that filters the water again. We added filtered water into the barrel from our whole house water filtration system, but there's going to be rain and stuff going in, so we wanted to make sure it's all filtered and there is no residue or smell or anything from, you know, the inside of the barrel. No red wine for sure. So we installed a charcoal filter, and from the charcoal filter we're going into the recirculation pump. Then we're going to show you later once we walk on the inside. The other thing that we did up here is we cut out a piece of, or we cut out an opening approximately that size so we can fit the bucket feeder into the barrel. Again, that heats the water if the temperature drops below 35 degrees Fahrenheit. And we added a mesh filter on top again to make sure that no mosquitoes, no animals, no debris, etc., can get into our barrel. All right, on the other side here, we drilled another hole for the return connection to get in, because once the recirculation pump kicks in, what it does is it recirculates the water, as the name implies, and it puts some of the water back into our barrel. And so that's what we've done here on the outside. And now let's walk on the inside and let's check out the copper pipe and what we've done on the inside. All right, so down here, here we cut a little opening into our mesh wire to get the hose in. And the hose is connected to this recirculation pump that's plugged into an outlet up there. And again, the recirculation pump kicks in if the temperatures drop. And from here, we are going into a copper pipe that I soldered. And it basically consists of a regular 2-inch pipe. I got a 10-foot pipe at a local plumbing store and then cut it to size. So this is, I think, 48 inches long, if I'm not mistaken, but all the measurements and all the parts and everything is down in the description, so you can look that up. And then we have some fittings, sleeves, reducers to be able to screw in the recirculation pump on this side and then the hose on the other side. And so soldering this was an experience, because I've never soldered anything before in my life, so I had to figure that out, buy all the tools. And it worked really well, except for on this side, it was leaking. And when we had plumbers at the house for another job, I asked them to fix that leak. So they did that for me real quick. They were much more efficient than I could have been. And once they fixed the leak, everything was working nicely. The other thing that I had to do that I never did before either was to tap a hole. Because when you drill a hole into the copper pipe is relatively thick. And those plastic nipples here, they have a threading, and so you cannot thread or screw those nipples into the drill hole. You need to tap it. So there's a special tap that has a thread on it, and you have to carefully, well, tap it, I guess. I have never done this before either. So it took, actually what I did is I took a piece of copper pipe, not this one, but a piece of the leftover pipe, and I practiced there. I highly recommend to do that until you have figured it out how it works. And then I started tapping here the holes. I have a hole every 11 inches or so with 4 nipples in total. And once we had that figured out, we screwed in the nipples, and everything was working fine. And I used some pipe fasteners here to attach it to the frame. So instead of the PVC pipe here, we got a 2-inch copper pipe. And what I did here on the end, so basically I used fittings to get the threading that I need on both sides. I have here half an inch male and quarter of an inch female that I'm gonna then screw in the pump on one side and then the return connection, the return hose on the other side. So this I did already up front. So the pipe is basically now ready for the holes. So I got a drill bit. I'm gonna put all the exact specs of the drill bit, etc., and the tap thing in the description below, so you'll see that then. But basically I'm gonna drill a hole first, a pilot hole, and then I'm gonna use this guy here to add the necessary threading. And that is necessary because, unlike a piece of thin plastic, the copper pipe is relatively thicker than the threading here, or the distance between the threads on those nipples. So I wouldn't be able to screw them in. It would leak if I just stick them in like so. And so I got this, I think it's called a tap, and that is a manual approach. So I'm gonna actually use one of the wrenches here to carefully add the thread. But first we're gonna be drilling the holes. I already marked them off here. We have 4 holes that we need, 11 inches apart. So one here, one here, one here, and then the other one here, I believe. So that's what we're gonna be doing. And I practiced on this piece of pipe first, and I'm glad I did this because I have never done this before. And I first used this bit, I thought I can just use a drill for it, and you can't. So I messed it up a few times, and I'm glad I messed it up on this one because copper is expensive. And so I didn't want to mess up my pipe that I have already soldered and everything. And so let's be still very careful, because there is a real risk of messing this up, and we don't want to do that. So we're going to start here. It's easier said than done if you don't have a stationary drill. You want to be careful, because once it's through, you don't want to mess up the backside of the pipe here. And then so here is then the next one.
That scared me.
It is scary. The next part here is highly unprofessional because there is like a special tool that you can use to carefully add that threading or that tap that hole. I don't have that and I was not patient enough to get it. So we're just gonna do it like so. The key here is to be again careful and not to mess up your drill hole. But this is basically adding the threading to the pipe that will make it then easy to screw in the nipple. And now I can feel it. It's biting. And I just do this. And if you get really close, I'm not sure if you can see it, you can actually see here the shavings of my threading here, and then you can go back a little bit to get out the shavings from number one. Now we're gonna give this a try. Perfect. So it screws in. Don't over tighten it because this is still plastic and you can easily mess up the threading, but I can see it's a nice tap here that works very well. Now we're gonna redo the same thing three more times. That was pretty much it. It was actually a fairly complex project simply based on the fact that I never did anything like that before. And so it was a learning curve, but it was an experience. It was certainly something that that I appreciated doing and learning. And the result is that we have a watering system now for our chickens that requires zero maintenance. I mean, maybe if it doesn't rain in weeks and weeks and weeks, we might have to refill the barrel, but that's pretty much it. There is no ongoing cleaning required. There is no concern in winter that it would freeze over. If you're in a very cold climate, you could wrap this barrel here in, you know, with some insulation if need be. I'm not sure if that would be even necessary down here in Georgia, certainly not. And yeah, that was pretty much it. And with that, we get a system that is completely, almost completely plastic free. We're going to replace those nipples here, but I'm not too concerned about that because there is not a lot of contact with the water, but everything else is plastic free, so nothing toxic. And we can be sure that our chickens don't get any chemicals into their bodies, and we don't eat any of that either. And so we are super happy about the system. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't like it, let us know in the comments below. Until next time.